The Yusupov princely family descends from Yusuf, one of the Huns of the powerful Nogai horde, a confederation of Turkic nomads formed in 1396 after the breakup of the Golden Horde on the territory in between Volga and the Irtysh. The Nogai horde concluded a peace treaty with Muscovy. Khan Yusuf wanted to terminate this treaty, but was killed by his brother, who, by way of guarantee of peaceful coexistence in the future, sent Yusuf's sons to serve in the Russian court. Since then, all descendants of the murdered Khan Yusuf lived in Moscow and were called princes. One of them, Abdul Mirza, converted to Orthodox Christianity and changed his name to Dmitri. The family chronicles narrate that on the day of his baptism, Dmitri saw in a dream Prophet Muhammad, who prophesied that his issue would be cursed for the apostasy. In any single generation, only one son would live until the age of 26. The rest will die. This prophecy was relentlessly fulfilled across five generations. Only one male heir survived. This curse was a tragedy for the family, but it also had a positive side. The material wealth of the dynasty multiplied through lucrative matrimonial alliances and loyal service to Russia was controlled by one single person. Nikolai Yusupov added a special luster to the dynasty. An artful diplomat, he was a good friend of Empress Catherine II and one of Russia's richest men. He married the Empress's favorite maid of honor, Tatiana Engelhard. The marriage was arranged by the Catherine the Great herself. Tatiana Engelhard had a dowry of 20 million rubles and started collecting gems. Prince Yusupov added to this collection paintings, books and statues. His most beloved estate, Arkhangelskaya, was his biggest investment. He wrote, "Because Arkhangelskaya is a money loser rather than money maker, a village for fun rather than for profit, it should be equipped with the rarest objects one can find and look better than the other gentlemen's homesteads." Nikolai's son Boris Yusupov inherited his princely title and wealth, but not his artistic nature. Boris did not like Arkhangelskaya and rarely visited it. Moreover, he rented out its main buildings as separate summer residences and took the best paintings and statues to his palace in St. Petersburg. Arkhangelskaya went to seed and came back to life only 50 years later. The next in line, Yusupov Nikolai, was to be the last direct male descendant. His only son died in infancy. Muhammad's curse still haunted the clan. Now all the assets were to be inherited by Nikolai Yusupov's daughters, Zinaida and Tatiana. The ladies became the richest potential brides in Russia. At 22, Tatiana died of typhus. The elder daughter, Zinaida, now the only heir to the family's wealth, married, in 1882, a standard-bearer of the Horse Guardsmen Regiment, Prince Felix Sumarokov-Elston. To make sure the family does not die out, Zinaida's father, the last scion of the Yusupov family, applied to the Emperor Alexander III with the request that after his death, the Yusupov's name, title and coat of arms be passed to Felix, Zinaida's spouse. The permission was granted. Now Zinaida's sons Nikolai and Felix had the right to bear the ancient family name of Yusupov. Zinaida knew about the family curse and hoped that it would not affect her kin. In summer, the Yusupovs would spend months at a time at Arkhangelskaya. The homestead experience, a renaissance. Zinaida and Felix made friends with members of the royal family who visited them often. The Arkhangelskaya estate was frequented by famed poets and artists. Valentin Serov accomplished portraits of Princess Zinaida, Prince Felix and their sons for the family collection. But the curse continued to haunt the clan. The elder son Nikolai died fighting a duel shortly before his 26th birthday. The younger offspring Felix remained the sole heir. In 1914 he married Princess Irina Romanova, Nikolai II's niece. A year later, they had a daughter, also called Irina. 4 years after, in 1919, the entire family left Russia after the Bolshevik Revolution and found shelter in France. That marked a new stage in the family history, exile. The Yusupovs managed to take with them quite a few valuables, paintings, furniture, jewelry. They had houses in Paris and Rome, a villa on the island of Corsica. In 1924, Irina and Felix opened in Paris a fashion house. Its appellation was composed of the first syllables of their names, IRFE. Irina had a distinct style, tread the catwalk herself, and hired as models daughters of Russian emigre noble families. There were no more boys in the family. The Yusupov name was not passed to anyone.